Hey everyone, do you know that the calendar is actually missing a whole year and a full 10 days? You do not have to believe me. Just pause the video right now, take your phone out, and go to October 1582. You will find that the calendar skipped from the 4th of October all the way to the 15th, making it a very, very short October. If you checked it out, you will know it's true. And since you stayed, it means you are intrigued enough to dive deeper into this mystery. Let's rewind time now, and go all the way back to ancient Egypt. We are at the peak of the civilization. Pyramids are being erected, religious storylines are being enacted, and calendars were being created. They were the first civilization to develop a calendar based on the cycles of the sun, which made it quite similar to our own, with Egyptian calendar being only 6 hours longer. Pretty cool for people who lived 5,000 years ago. We forward time a bit and reach the Roman era. The Romans have come and become the alpha male of the world, pushing everyone in their place, waging wars, conquering nations, and building roads. And on top of all that, they decided to play a bit with the calendar itself. The great Julius Caesar reformed the previously used calendar into the currently known year cycle of 365 days, with each fourth year being a leap year with 366 days. The reform also inelegantly added two more months, pushing the month of October, octo meaning 8, to the 10th place, greatly annoying one of my weird friends. The calendar was introduced in 45 BC and it was named the Julian Calendar after, you guessed it, Julian Caesar himself. Such a modest guy. With great influence of the Roman Empire, the calendar spread and was soon adapted by many parts of Europe, staying in service for around 1200 years, until the 16th century, when it was replaced by our current calendar. Well, mostly replaced, as some countries got a bit late notice on that change. The one and only Russia, which finally changed it in the 20th century. And here it is, our first culprit in this mystery. Although, it is a bit of a mathematical one. Man, math always making our life complicated. Even though zero did exist at the time in numerous countries, it wasn't until much later that it became a number in Europe. What this means is that the Julian calendar went from 1 BC to 1 AD, the year of the Lord, which you guessed it, is our missing year. Take that, Caesar. Zero for you and one for math. Now here's a cute picture of a cat wearing a pope hat to help you forget about all that math. Anyway, we move into a bit of spirituality and to a conclusion of our mystery. Pope Gregory VIII decided to make a reform of his own. Julius' calendar, as we earlier mentioned, was fairly correct, but not perfect. As the year passed, the season started to drift apart, and the calendar became more and more unaligned with the time that it takes the Earth to make a full circle around the sun, also known as a solar year. With that unalignment, important Christians' holiday and some other cultural event started to drift away from the season they were supposed to be in. To correct this drift, the Gregorian calendar introduced a new rule for the leap years. Under the Julian calendar, a leap year was any year that was divisible by 4. However, under the Gregorian calendar, a leap year is only a year that is divisible by 4, unless it is also divisible by 100, but not by 400. To simplify this, let us take the example of the year 2000, the millennial year, which was a leap year. But 1900 and 1800 weren't, and 2100 won't be either. As a result of these changes, the Gregorian calendar is about 11 minutes shorter than the Julian calendar, on average of course, which means that it loses about 3 days every 400 years. And with these rule changes, to bring back the calendar in line with the seasons and the solar year, the Gregorian calendar added 10 days to the Julian calendar in 1852, skipping, as we said from the start, from 4th of October to the 15th. With that, we have now solved the second part of our mystery, the missing 10 days. Hopefully, that explains and justifies the title of the video, and the mystery as a whole. One last note worth mentioning about our Gregorian calendar, is that if we average the number of days, we find out that each year is 365 days, 2425, which only pulls out of sync from the true year length by about 27 seconds with each passing year. Which is pretty awesome, as you will not have to mess with our calendar for the next 3200 years. At which point, we will all die. At which point, it will be off by a single day. Not bad for 16th century humans. Ah, but also, final note, I promise you, this is the last one. This is all true if two theories remain correct. The Earth spinning on its axis will always take the same amount to complete a full 360 degrees rotation as it does today. And that the Earth revolving around the Sun will always follow the same precise orbit that it follows today as well. Hopefully, no meteorite decide to uncorrect this, and that's what I would call a spiritual ending. In conclusion, time is a concept created by humanity that has a profound impact on our understanding and experience of the world. It helps us to measure and understand the passage of events, and gives us a sense of structure and order in our lives. Time is an integral part of our daily life. It shapes the way we think, plan, and interact with one another. So, whether we use a calendar to keep track of it or not, it has a real and undeniable effect on our lives, helping us to make sense of the world around us and providing us with a sense of purpose and direction. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.